So we're here in Charlestown at the Wind Technology Testing Center, in which the Mass Clean Energy Center works with manufacturers to test the durability and lifespan of these enormous wind turbine blades that you see behind me. So I'm standing inside one of these enormous fiberglass wind turbine blades that has just been tested for months. Two things that are really interesting about this. One is that you can see that the blade is mostly hollow. And so a lot of what they're moving back and forth is air, but yet these blades are all at least 20 tons. That gives you a sense of how large they are. And that is because when you're producing wind energy, the blade being bigger means a lot more power being generated. The second thing you can really notice is that the blade is much larger than me. And this part is what they mount on the wall for the kind of stress tests and life tests that we'll learn about inside. So we're here inside the Wind Technology Testing Center. This is where the magic happens. And this is Rahul. What's happening, Rahul, and what's your role in all of this?
So what you see behind us is we're testing large wind turbine blades. You can design the most efficient blade, but we have to make sure they survive. First, we receive the blade. We do some basic measurements, weight, natural frequency, and all of that. But then the idea is we test them to make sure they survive high wind speed. The idea is not to test and break them. The idea is to bring them, prepare them. They have about 200 to 300 sensors, and we apply the load, and we tell our customer what we are observing so they can make sure their designs, their computer models, their manufacturing setup, everything is correct. In the control room is where we crunch all the numbers. We get a lot of data because we have 200 to 300 sensors, and that captures the data that's processed by our engineers and sent to our customers every other day or so.
How do you simulate what the blade is experiencing in terms of, you know, the air going by it and the force and the torque on it?
So they have weather models which tell them here's the wind pattern, and based on that they use computational fluid dynamics, and there's a lot of other stress related tools, numerical tools that allow them to combine what the weather patterns, how the blade would react. So we do like 5 or 6 directions where the customer says this is the worst case. We want to make sure they don't break in a high wind situation or a mechanical failure or something.
How many places are there where you can test blades this large?
So this is the only place in the United States, probably 7 or 8 in the whole world that do this.
How is this place helping to advance renewable energy in our Commonwealth?
So Massachusetts Commonwealth is doing a lot of things. It's a leader in offshore wind. So what we do here is we want to make sure when we put up those turbines, they work. Because even if it's a valid reason, if they put up these turbines and they break, it's a bad reputation for the industry, for all the people who are for wind energy, which is one of the cleanest form of generating electricity. So we want to make sure they work properly.